of Superman. Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Look, up in the sky, it's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's Superman. Yes, it's Superman. Strange visitor from another planet who came to Earth with powers and abilities far beyond those of mortal men. Superman, who can change the course of mighty rivers, bend steel in his bare hands, and who, disguised as Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan newspaper, fights a never-ending battle for truth, justice, and the American way.
Stop me if you've heard this before. The FBI is at it again, following up on a new tip in the disappearance of Jimmy Hoffa, the Teamster's boss last seen 46 years ago in Bloomfield Township. The latest search taking place in Jersey City, New Jersey. Local 4 defender Sean Lay brings us up to speed on the investigation. Sean, this case does seem to pop up every few years.
Well, Devin, it's a case that continues to captivate. It continues to captivate Hollywood. Jimmy Hoffa case. But listen, it still is a case that belongs to the Detroit FBI office. It is their case because of the Bloomfield Township connection. And the Detroit FBI office is backing up FBI agents in the New York, New Jersey area with this new tip. So today I got to ask the FBI special agent in charge here in the Detroit region about this new lead.
Last month, the FBI obtained a search warrant to conduct a site survey underneath the Pulaski Skyway in New Jersey. On October 25th and 26th, FBI personnel from the Newark and Detroit field offices completed the survey, and that data is currently being analyzed. Because of the affidavit being sealed, I'm not able to provide any additional information.
That's Devin Kowalski, special agent in charge of the FBI's Detroit field office, talking about the missing persons case of Jimmy Hoffa, a case that has always been a Detroit FBI case since Jimmy Hoffa went missing from Bloomfield Township. Detroit agents now assisting FBI agents working in Jersey City, New Jersey. New search warrants, new leads from new tips from what the New York Times says is from a deathbed statement from a man who says he buried a drum containing Hoffa's remains in what was a landfill. Journalist Dan Moldia, who has written extensively about the Hoffa case, says he generated this new lead in the case.
He said there was a place called Moscato's Dump on the Pulaski Skyway, and that's where we would dump bodies. And so that was the baseline for which the FBI has operated. That is the baseline from which I have operated.
FBI telling us today, look, one thing is for sure about this new dig is that there's no timetable for it. They're going to take their time. They're going to dig. But again, they're going to take their time and see what's in there. We're going to watch it every step of the way, though. Devin, back to you.
Sure will, because you're right, John. We can't quite turn away. All right, John.
Little snicker on his face. Well, back to this individual. Now, when I was growing up, this show was on television in the 50s, and I could not help myself but to watch it. And then later in life, I learned actor George Reeves committed suicide. Oh, yeah. His career was going so badly, he had to kill himself. And then, of course, about in the late 50s, there was a mysterious figure called Jimmy Hoffa. And Jimmy Hoffa stole some money from the truckers' union and gave it to the so-called mafia. And eventually, Jimmy Hoffa disappeared. And there have been many jokes about finding Jimmy Hoffa's body. You don't have to worry about finding Jimmy Hoffa's body. I found him. You guessed it. Yep, you guessed it. Say, on the left is Jimmy Hoffa. On the right is Superman. George Reeves. On the left, Jimmy Hoffa. On the right, actor George Reeves. Better yet, with pick try of Jimmy Hoffa on the left, George Reeves on the right. There are no superheroes. There are only super liars. George Reeves, Superman, was a liar. Because he played the role of Jimmy Hoffa, the Teamsters' boss, who was taking money from their retirement fund and their health care fund and giving it to what people think are the mafia. Incidentally, I tried to show on some of my other channels, there's no mafia. The mafia didn't build Las Vegas. It was all associated with the government. Fake mafia figures, such as Al Capone, who was really Fatty Arbuckle, the actor, and on it goes. Now, I kind of told myself I wasn't going to do any more videos like this, but I couldn't help it, and it's mostly because of Superman here. When I was growing up, I loved this show, and later I found out he killed himself. And I got suspicious of it over the years. And when I really came awake, I said, somewhere, somehow, he plays someone. And I just couldn't quite put my finger on it. And then one day I was doing a little bit of research on this character. And I said, you know what? I think I recognize him. I think it's George Reeves. So, superhero. Supervillain. George Reeves never committed suicide. George Reeves played Jimmy Hoffa. No superheroes, just super liars. Once again, the source of all truth is God's Word in the Holy Spirit. And I'd like to thank you for watching this video. This concludes my video.